We're learning new information this morning about what happened. Chris Immel is in West Palm Beach with what led up to this late night shooting. Chris, I know you've been there all morning at St. Mary's Medical Center. What have we learned about what exactly transpired between police and the suspects?
Well, Paul, we're at St. Mary's Medical Center where that police officer who was shot last night is recovering this morning after that deadly shootout at the Springbrook Common Apartments. Now, here's what happened. This was all around 10 o'clock last night. A man was shot in the face by another man after an argument at the apartment complex in the parking lot. Now, the victim who was shot, he was able to drive himself with a female companion that he was with to a nearby gas station, and that's where they called police. So police answered to that call, and when they showed up to the apartment complex looking for the suspect, that's when the suspect came out and began firing on the police cruisers at the two officers that showed up. That victim, the suspect, shot out the back window of one of the police cruisers and also shot one of the officers in the shoulder during that firefight. Now, the suspect was shot and killed on the scene, and police say that the wounded officer did exactly what he was supposed to do.
Your instincts kick in, and your initial training from the academy on through field training officers and just what you go through on the road, it becomes second nature, and it just kicks in, and you begin doing what you're professionally taught to do.
Well, fellow officers of that five-year veteran, the officer who was wounded, they say that he's a hero for returning fire even after he was wounded in that shoulder. And again, we're told that he is expected to make a full recovery. He's here resting at St. Mary's Medical Center. That victim who was shot in the face, he is also expected to live and be okay, and he is also here as well. Reporting live from West Palm Beach, I'm Chris Emma, WPBF 25 News.